Japan is known for having seriously weird movies. Sometimes disturbing, and sometimes just plain out balls-to-the-wall goofiness. Such as this one. Are you a fan of professional wrestling? Have you ever fantasized of seeing your favorite pro wrestlers going toe-to-toe with sea creatures? Well, this might just be the movie for you. Welcome to Dumb Down, the show where we summarize movies in hopes of understanding them better. Today, we dumb down the Calamari Wrestler. Koji Taguchi is a wrestler at the top of his game. He's making motherfuckers tap out, left and right. But things are about to change. Upon retaining his championship title, his belt is snatched away by a mysterious new challenger. Who is this mysterious challenger, you ask? Well, the Calamari Wrestler, of course. Koji gets destroyed by this human squid. After seeing the Calamari Wrestler deliver a suplex, several people in the audience, including Koji's girlfriend, Miyako, comes to believe that the squid is the reincarnation of the previous champion, Kenichi Iwata, whom she also has dated in the past. I guess she only fucks champions. Kenichi Iwata had disappeared from the wrestling business after succumbing to an unexplained terminal illness. I guess he's the only person in the world that can do a suplex in that way. Okay, I'll buy it. So the owners of the wrestling company are not too happy with this fucking squid coming over and making their champion look like a goddamn fool.
You a damn fool.
So they proposition a fixed rematch to the Calamari Wrestler. They want him to give them a show, but to purposely lose in the end. But the squid is way too honorable to accept, so he politely tells them to go fuck themselves. So they decide to ban his slippery ass from wrestling altogether. Forever. Well, not forever, just till a bit later in the movie. The Calamari Wrestler retreats to a temple to train and meditate. Here we see that all this fucking squid thinks about is naked chicks. One naked chick in particular, Miyako, his ex-girlfriend. He later stops by her crib on creep mode, and she tells him to fuck off. And here's where we witness, for the first time, a super sad giant squid. Miyako continues to question just who this Calamari Wrestler really is. So she follows him around and eventually finds out that he in fact actually is Kenichi Iwata. And you know how? Because anything he fucking does reminds her of the way Kenichi used to do things. Like when he walks a certain way, or even the way he picks up and plays with strangers' kids at the park. Eventually, the owners of the wrestling company change their minds upon realizing that this match will make them a fuck ton of money. Because the Calamari Wrestler has become very popular, not only in the wrestling community, but also in his neighborhood. So now Koji leaves the country in order to train for the rematch against the Calamari Wrestler, while at the same time Miyako tries to decide being with Koji or the Calamari Wrestler. So eventually, after talking to her sister, she decides to go with her old flame turned squid, Kenichi. Now we have another montage. This one is of them falling in love with each other again. Look into my eyes, you will see what you mean to me. Search your heart, search your soul, and when you find me there, you'll search no more. Don't tell me it's not worth trying. They even get it on, human-female on squid cock action. We discover that once the squid succumbs to temptation, he reverts back to human form. And this is where we see Kenichi's human form for the first time in the movie. But when he reverts, so does his terminal illness. So he needs to change back to squid form as fast as possible in order to remain alive. So he goes to his monk friends and they help him become squid again. The night everyone has been waiting for has finally arrived. As you can tell from how happy all these people from this concert crowd stock footage are, the Calamari Wrestler heads the ring, but as Koji is about to calm down and face him, we get hit with the mother of all surprises. Koji has turned himself into an octopus in order to battle the Calamari. Makes perfect sense, right?
Wrong.
Now we have the final battle. One of the most unintelligible fights I've ever seen in a movie. The quote-unquote wrestling match is edited together with the same stock footage clips over and over. They fight hard, but the Calamari Wrestler comes out on top. And just when the whole world is in his corner, and they want nothing else but to talk to him, they pull a move right out of Rocky. He doesn't care about any of them. He just calls out for his true love, Adrian. Miyako. And so, Miyako and Kenichi, in squid form, live happily ever after. The end. Well, actually, not the end. I was hoping that was the end, but when I checked the running time, there was still 30 fucking minutes left. Jesus Christ, what could be left? So now the Squid and Miyako are chilling. The Squid is wearing kick-ass sunglasses and they're out doing some shopping. The Calamari Wrestler gets ambushed by the Squilla Boxer, a giant human shrimp that challenges him to a wrestling match.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Of course. Who couldn't have expected this? Kenichi gets Koji to help him train, and after yet another goddamn montage scene, this one is Rocky style. It's just a regular old squid putting in time at the gym.
Training like a damn bum, you know that?
The big night has finally arrived. The giant shrimp versus the giant squid in a battle for the ages. Huge crowds have gathered and the CGI budget has gone out the window because we get shots like this. So they face each other in the truest final showdown. Calamari Wrestler comes out victorious, and just as everyone starts celebrating, it is revealed to us who the Squilla Boxer truly is. He is none other than Godozan, a famous professional wrestler from war-era Japan.
Godozan!
He was famous for helping lift the Japanese people in post-war Japan. And this is where the movie goes to complete shit. Godozan reveals to be both Koji and Kenichi's father. The movie barely mentioned before that they both didn't know who their father was, but neither of them seemed to give a fuck about looking for their father. And now they drop this here as some sort of fucking twist? Here they do what any sons would do after finding the father that abandoned them for their entire life. They embrace him in a glorious hug, and they all live happily ever after. Another unexplained nonsense is that Kenichi can now somehow survive in his true form. The terminal illness from before, out the fucking window.
Well, that was pointless.
The one time they had sex was not for nothing, because now Miyako and Kenichi are parents to a beautiful baby squid. This has been the Calamari Wrestler Dump Down. A very silly movie starring several real-life professional wrestlers that were in on the joke. If you don't take this movie seriously, you can have a good time with it. And if you're expecting something serious, maybe look elsewhere. I am sorry if I mispronounce any of these names. I do not speak Japanese. Make sure you like this video, subscribe, follow us on Instagram, and tell all your friends.
See ya! Bye!
the fuck out of here now.